We had to be aggressive. We had to show them, you know, with them just strolling through the front gate like they owned the place, we couldn't let them do that.
Romesha's plan was to secure the north side of camp, and he would need others to join him.
I asked for volunteers and gave them a quick idea of the plan. I said, we'll take this bitch back. And I'd watch Raz and Delaney and Jones, Sergeant Miller. They just followed, you know. Didn't hesitate. Didn't question.
I'd rather go out there and let them kill me and not kill a few of them than just sit here and let them do it.
You ran right into places where others had been killed. You weren't worried? You weren't afraid?
There wasn't time to be.
There's few people I would follow to hell and back, and Romesha is one of them.
Romesha and his men pushed out of the Red Platoon barracks with the ultimate goal of making it to the Shura building. They would travel this route, and the enemy would unleash an intense concentration of fire. The Americans returned fire in every direction.
I remember seeing a Taliban fighter coming straight up the road, unslinging his AK and Danley yelling at him to stop. And I brought my M4 over the top, started engaging as I'm yelling to get down, and Raz starts prepping grenades out of his pouch, and Danley takes one to the shoulder, drops to the ground. Danley was lying there grabbing his shoulder and picked him up, and grabbed a field dressing to patch him up with, and shoved him in the direction of the aid station, and he made the mad dash.
But there were still Taliban fighters in the American camp. Over the radio, the camp's lieutenant in charge told Romesha to stand by, but Romesha felt he had no time to lose, so he pretended his radio was broken.
I knew we still had enemy in the wire, and I got tactically impatient. I was worried that, like I said, we were going to finally make it out to positions and find no bodies left to bring home.
So we came out Red Platoon Barracks.
Securing the north side of camp and recovering the bodies of his brothers would mean storming a building with no idea who might be in there. The plan? Rasmussen would fire a grenade. Romesha and Delaney would burst in, sweeping the room with machine gun fire.
We got the head nod from each other, and that's when I asked him, are you guys ready to follow me into this?
What did Raz say?
It was something to the effect of, yeah, I'll follow you anywhere.
You look back and you just see like the determination in his eyes and the not give up, and every time you looked at him, you're motivated to keep going. And I don't think anybody better could have been in the position, and I think he was definitely meant to be there that day.
Romesha, Rasmussen, and Delaney recaptured the building, and with it, a better view of the enemy. Romesha and his men began calling in targets to be hit by air support. But across the compound, five men were still stuck in that Humvee, and no one had heard from them in far too long. They were feared dead, including Romesha's friend, Sergeant Brad Larson. Suddenly, surprising news.
Lieutenant Bunderman called me on the radio and said, you wouldn't believe it, but Larson's still alive.
And so were two others trapped in the Humvee.
Bunderman asked, do you think you could put enough firepower out to cover their move if we coordinate this with an airstrike? I told Bunderman, yeah, we'll make it happen.
Lieutenant Andrew Bunderman coordinated with a B-1 bomber to target the village of Urmul, which had become a staging ground for the enemy.
What was it like when you heard that bomb dropping on Urmul?
Damn, that's close. I mean, it was close.
It's a big bomb.
Massive bomb. It was like being inside the bass drum. I mean, just compressed and just intense. I remember calling back to Lieutenant Bunderman and telling him, I'm not a structural engineer, but I don't know how much longer this mud hut can take it. And he called back and said, you want me to stop? And returned the call and said, no, keep it coming. We'll deal with it later.
As the bombs began dropping, Romesha and his troops sprinted out of the building and into the open, spraying fire toward the enemy and providing cover for the three survivors in the Humvee to run to safety.